Good morning. Welcome to Morning Expresso. You're watching Indian Express. I'm Charulata Biswas. Let's get you started with the big story of the day. The Bombay High Court will hear Aryan Khan's bail petition in the drugs case today, a day before a special NDPS court in Mumbai refused to pass a blanket order barring authorities from taking cognizance of an affidavit of an independent witness, Prabhakar Sel, who accused the NCB director and others of trying to extort money from Khan. The NCB has initiated a vigilance inquiry against the director, who flew to Delhi last night. Here are the stories you will find only in Indian Express. The probe into the case against climate activist Disha Ravi, who was arrested in February in connection with a toolkit on the farmer protests, has come to a standstill. With neither Google nor Zoom responding to queries by investigators, the police will most likely not file a charge sheet against Ravi, but file a closure report in the case. Caught in the midst of a slugfest between former Punjab CM Amrinder Singh and Congress leaders, Pakistan journalist Arusa Alam said she was extremely disappointed and disgusted with Punjab Congress leaders and would never come back to India, as she was hurt and heartbroken. Teams at the T20 World Cup have been taking the knee after the International Cricket Council offered them the opportunity to show their support against racism and discrimination. There was no directive in this regard, leaving it to team management to decide. India took the knee before the start of their match against Pakistan on Sunday. Here are the stories from the front page. Removing the bulletproof frame around the podium, Union Home Minister Amit Shah on Monday spoke his Mann Ki Baat in a public meeting in Srinagar. He said that if talks on Jammu and Kashmir have to be held, he will speak to his brothers and sisters in the valley and the youth in the valley. Lucknow and Ahmedabad are the two new franchises in IPL, the former becoming the most valued side so far. The Sanjeev Goenka-led RPSG Group will be guarding IPL's northern outpost after shelling out 7,090 crore, while private equity firm Irelia Company Private Limited forked out 5,625 crores to head west and make the world's biggest cricket stadium at Motera their home. Here are the must-reads. What is the harassment of Aryan Khan really about? In an opinion column, Pratap Bhanu Mehta writes, "The point is not to say that Aryan Khan is equal before the law. The point is to say we can make life miserable even for Aryan Khan. First, it sends a signal to create a generalized climate of fear where everyone feels vulnerable. Second, there is an ideological war on a constructed Muslimness." You can read the column on IndianExpress.com. Outreach events targeting youth and women, a rising social media presence, spotlight on leaders other than the party chief, an eye on Ayodhya, and a promise to learn from the past. Pushed to electoral margins over the last decade, Mayawati's BSP is going all out with a revamped approach in the run-up to the Uttar Pradesh elections. The law is settled that marriage is a term associated with a biological man and a biological woman, the centre argued on Monday before the Delhi High Court. The court was hearing petitions seeking recognition and registration of same-sex marriages under existing laws. The final hearing in the case is on November 30th. Using a cobra as a murder weapon, a 54-year-old man in Maharashtra's Ahmednagar district staged his own death by killing a destitute man in order to claim a $5 million life insurance policy with a US-based insurance firm. However, the plot unraveled and police arrested the accused and four of his accomplices. And finally, in today's Delhi Confidential, the CEO of FIFA Foundation paid a visit to Sports Minister Anurag Thakur on Monday and discussed with him measures to encourage football at the grassroots level and to expand it with more tournaments in India. After the meeting, the CEO also displayed his football skills in the lawns of Thakur's residence. That's a wrap from my end. For more news updates, subscribe to our channel, Indian Express. Thank you for watching.